Good morning, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Allison. It's so early, it's Saturday, it is 7:39. I'm gonna be late for an appointment. I have an eye appointment this morning, and then I am going to be getting sew-in hair extensions today, which if you know me, it's kind of a big deal for me. I've never done this before. I have my like regular extensions that I just put in when I feel like it, like on weekends and stuff. This is my hair right now, just short, and this is my last day with short hair, and I'm like kind of freaking out. So I'm gonna go to my eye appointment, and then I'm gonna bring you guys along for the hair process. I'm so excited, and I really gotta go because I'm gonna be late, but happy Saturday. I hope you enjoyed the video. Sorry for that rushed intro this morning. I just got out of my eye appointment. It is literally so gross out. Like, it's been so gloomy and rainy in Boston. And I'm just so over it. Like, I thought we were past that. I thought we were into warm weather, but I guess not. Oh my God, I can't get this off my earring. I had to go just for like my annual checkup, but also I was trying to renew my glasses prescription because I'm about to be getting some new prescription glasses. The appointment's at 10 o'clock, so I might just drive back home and then drive back out to my hair appointment. So I'm like really, really nervous. I mean, I'm sure I'm gonna love them and I'm sure they're gonna look good, but I feel like I'm like leaving a part of me behind. Like, I'm not gonna have my short hair. It's just so weird. Okay, I'll see you later. God. Guys, I'm freaking out. This is my hair. Like, this is my own hair. Like, I know it really doesn't look that different. Like, it's not a huge transformation because I always wear my extensions. You guys always see me in my extensions in my videos. But to me, like, it's sewn in my hair. Like, this is my real hair. I'm like so freaking happy because I never felt that way about my extensions. Like, when I put them in, you feel them, they're annoying, they don't feel like they're part of your like head. Anyone that has like clip-ins or the halo ones like I have, like, you know the struggle. It just, I don't know, like, it looks good, sure, but you just don't feel like it's yours. And this is a whole new feeling. First step was ordering the actual hair extensions. So I ordered it through my salon. So depending on where you go, I mean, I guess you could order it yourself too, but they use Bellamy hair extensions, which actually is a really good hair company. Like, you could go and buy your own extensions from them, like the clip-ins or whatever. I've never used Bellamy. You guys know I always use Hidden Crown, but Bellamy is also a really good option. I go to the same girl, she colors my hair, so she knew like what one would look good with my hair, what one would be like perfect match. So I actually got one with a root. I have a dark root, so I got one that had the same exact dark root as me, so that if it like shows through, it doesn't look fake. So I would definitely recommend doing that. And then I got the blonde that like completely just matched my hair, and I'll also link it down below in case you want to order it too. But basically, yeah, you could just go on Bellamy's site and order your own hair extensions if you just want temporary ones, but this is how my salon does it. So this whole process, I'm not gonna lie, it's wicked expensive. Like, this is definitely a commitment, especially because you have to keep up with it. But for me, it was just so worth it because I spent so much money on like clip-ins and the halo extensions anyway, that I was like, I might as well just make it my own hair and like be able to wear it 24/7, because I never wore my extensions during the weekday. I never wore them to work. It'll take all of that like annoyance away of like having to put it in and having to make it look good. So the actual hair was $439, which I know is pricey, but if you wanna buy a good set of extensions and like you're committed to this and you want it to look good, you gotta spend the money. That's just what it is with hair. So it was $439 for the hair. And then to get them sewn into my head, it was $250. And then that is without tip. I also always tip at least 20% when I go. Yeah, it was around maybe $800 total. Then to keep up with it, you have to go back every 6 to 8 weeks to have them moved up because they are on a bead and they do slip down the more like you wash them, you sleep on them, whatever. So you do have to keep up with it. I go every 3 months to get my hair colored anyway, so it's not really a big deal to me. I will just go a little bit more so that I can get my extensions moved up. So I know it's a lot of money, but to me it's so worth it. Like, I already feel so much more confident about myself. I've just never had long hair. I've always wanted long hair. I do everything to make my hair grow and it just doesn't work out for me. So my hair doesn't look good, I don't feel good, so to me it's worth it to spend money on my hair rather than something else. Like, I know other people like getting lash extensions or getting like their eyebrows done or whatever. Like, this is just what I choose to spend my personal money on and what makes me personally feel good. So moral of the story, do what makes you happy, and yeah, you only live once. She inserted them into my head. They were never washed fresh out the bag. So when you first get hair extensions, it's literally like a doll's hair. They're really fine, they're really silky, and that really doesn't match anyone's hair. So right now, I mean, you can't really tell, but it's not that textured, and my hair is extremely textured, so I'm really excited to give them their first wash. That's really when it's gonna make it look like real hair. It's gonna get a little more thickness to it, a little more texture, and it'll blend more seamlessly that way. Also, she told me that when I go to bed at night, it's important to keep it in like a low ponytail, just like that, like a light low ponytail, or even braid it. Keep it in a low braid so that it doesn't get tangled. She did warn me and say that it might itch, just because there's like little hairs by the beads, and I don't know, just the way she was explaining it, she said, don't worry about it, it's normal, like nothing's wrong with your scalp, that's just how it is sometimes. And also, you know, you might feel a little pressure or like soreness. The whole process took maybe like an hour. It didn't take that long, it did not hurt at all, it was really easy. And I think I have maybe three, she put three rows in my hair, so depending on like how thick or thin your hair is, you can get a different amount of rows. And she was like, if you think it's too much, let me know, we can adjust it, or if you think it's too long, we can cut it. At first when she put it in, I was like, oh my god, it's so long. But after she like angled it and trimmed it and everything, I think it's actually the perfect length. Like, I'm not gonna spend all of this money and then just cut all the hair off, so I definitely like the length. I'm not gonna cut it. And as far as like care, using like sulfate free shampoo conditioner, I use Briogeo, but she did give me this Matrix Total Result Length Goals shampoo and conditioner to use, developed with Bellamy, so it's made for the extension. Also, as far as brushes, she did say that I can use a wet brush when my hair is wet and that'll be fine. So that's what I use anyway. And really, there's not much different now. I just don't ever have to put my extensions in again and I can just have this hair 24/7. I live in Boston and I go to this place called Behind the Hair. If you're interested, they do the sew-in extensions. They also do tape-ins. I don't recommend getting tape-in extensions, but they do them, and they do all kinds of things there. They do makeup there sometimes too, but that is also where I get my hair colored, and I just love it. I think it's such a great salon. It's really bougie in there, and it's like so my style, so my vibe. So if you guys have any questions about the extensions, or if you want to see maybe like an updated video in a couple months and see how I'm still liking them, but yeah, I'm so happy. Hey guys, ignore my appearance. It's like a Wednesday, I'm working from home today. This is how I look on weekdays, but I just got in an exciting PR package, a couple actually, and I am gonna create Instagram content with it, but I also wanted to show it on here because they're both companies that I am super obsessed with. So we have two packages, one from Lounge, which is my favorite like loungewear underwear brand. It's a UK company, I'm obsessed with them. They have like the cutest sets. I've worked with them before, so I was so excited when they sent me another one of their sets. I'm working with a new company. I'm not entirely sure how to pronounce it. I think it's like Maison de Sabre, definitely butchering that, but they have the cutest leather goods. They're all such high quality pieces, and you guys know I just got a new phone, so I picked out a phone case and I personalized it and I'm so obsessed with it, so I can't wait to show you. my god. Wait, I'm so excited. This is awesome.
Oh, this is so cute. Look at this box. Love Lounge, just like the sleek black. Oh my god, it's so pretty. I'm crying. This is so beautiful. Oh my god. Like, are you kidding? Look at the wrapping paper and then the leather. And then I wanted to personalize it and have my initials, Allison Rose Oatley, but you can obviously put whatever you want. Like, you could even make it say something. Oh my god, it feels so smooth and soft. I'm obsessed. I cannot wait to put that on my phone. I've literally had this phone probably for like 2 weeks now. I already have a crack in the screen. I have a screen protector on it, but I already have a crack in the screen, and it's been so scary having it like this, and I've just been waiting for this case to come in, so I'm so excited. I just put it on my phone and like, ah, it's perfect. It's the matcha green. They have so many good colors. I like seriously couldn't choose, but I figured this was like a fun spring color. I liked the gold too. I feel like it's just so me, and I'm so excited. So I wanted to get like a more, I don't know, just like a cozy one that I could actually wear around the house. Like, I would wear this without anything over it. So the bottoms are like full coverage, just like nice and comfy. And then the sports bra, which I don't know if this is gonna fit. It looks kind of big. I got the bottoms in a medium and then the top in a large, but I mean, it has the adjustables on it, so I can probably make it work, but it's so cute. They're just so classic. They have so many different styles, and even some of their more like lingerie-ish sets are so beautiful, and the colors are so pretty. So also check out Lounge.
But two more exciting packages that I wanted to share with you guys. One of them's for another video, so I guess I won't share that one, but one of them I definitely want to add into my PR haul.
Okay, so in this package, I got it from Bloom, which if you guys don't know Bloom, they are a clean, like, beauty skincare company, and I have not tried any of their products yet, so I'm so excited. I picked out the deodorant, one, because I ran out of my deodorant, and I haven't really made the switch to a natural deodorant. I feel like I tried Native, I've been using, like, Tom's right now, I don't even know, but I have not found a good deodorant that works for me, so I'm so pumped to try this. It's called the Hug Me, the best deodorant ever, and all of their ingredients are obviously really clean. They're all good for the environment, cruelty-free, vegan, I don't know, just some good natural products. I'm so excited to try them. I'm always down to try, like, new, clean products. And then I also picked up this Meltdown oil for acne-prone skin. So I don't have like a huge acne problem, but with my mask lately, like, my maskne has been so freaking bad. Like, I've been getting like cystic acne on my chin from wearing my mask all day at work. So I just wanted to try this. I thought it would be good. My code is AROATLY10. I'll have it on the screen. I'll also have it linked down below in the description box so you can shop some of their products. But I'm so excited to try this. Thank you, Bloom. Okay, this is what they look like out of the boxes. They're so cute. Look at this deodorant. I love the packaging. They're just like little perfect aesthetic to put on the shelf. Oh, I love them. They're so cute.
If the deodorant smells like anything. No, it doesn't. It doesn't smell like anything. It just looks like this, but... Use a drop or two on your fingertips to gently pat onto problem areas. Mix with moisturizer or a mask for extra absorbency. Okay, so you can mix it with a moisturizer too. That's good to know. I was just going to use it as like a spot treatment, but that's cool that you can do both.
Pumped.